Meanwhile, coming up next, the Missouri Valley Conference Championship from St. Louis. Dick Enberg and Clark Kellogg standing by to call the action for you after this word from your local station.
The Sapa Center in St. Louis, record crowds for this Missouri Valley Conference Championship run. It's Arch Madness, presented by State Farm, Bradley Braves, Southern Illinois Salukis, to battle for the tournament title. Wichita State won the regular season championship. In red, the Bradley Braves. This is Daniel Ruffin, led the league in assists. Somerville, big seven-footer now, O'Brien. And it's Tony Bennett. Outside, the Ruffin left alone. Good rotation, and from outside, Twy unable to connect. Rebound to Somerville. Somerville and O'Brien. Two big men inside for Southern Illinois. Patrick O'Brien, the seven-footer from Blaine, Minnesota for Bradley, has the first basket of the game. The big guy inside. The Sabbath Center in St. Louis. That's Randal Falker for the Southern Illinois Salukis. 2-2 early going here for the Missouri Valley Conference Tournament Championship. In red, the Bradley Braves. Daniel Ruffin, their point guard. Somerville, their veteran forward at 6'7". Twy doesn't score much. Tough defender. Inside is O'Brien, the seven-footer. He scored the first bucket of the game for the Braves. Outsized are the men in white, Southern Illinois, as roll is there for O'Brien. He has the first 4 points for Bradley. Southern Illinois with a pair of 6'7 wings. They're tallest starters. You got the big seven-footer O'Brien for Bradley with all that advantage. Tony Young outside to the freshman, and he's unable to hit, far short. Bryan Mullins playing on an injured ankle. He twisted an ankle in overtime in the win yesterday against Northern Iowa. Overtime. Well off the mark is Tony Bennett. And the whistle and foul. Dick Enberg with Clark Kellogg here at Sava Center. Jim Less, the head coach of the Bradley Braves. He was the most valuable player in the conference with Bradley back in 86 and was the Pomeroy National Player of the Year. That goes to the best player in the country under 6 feet tall. And it's his first winning season in his fourth year back on the Bradley campus.
Brings a lot of fire to that sideline. His team has really picked it up defensively during this seven-game winning streak they're enjoying right now.
Hottest team in the conference coming into this tournament. And they've proven themselves with two good wins against Evansville and Northern Iowa. Out of bounds to Bradley. There's Chris Lowry, one of the youngest coaches in Division I. 33 years young is Lowry. He played just like Less at Bradley. Lowry was a point guard for Southern Illinois, graduating back in 95, trying to become the first man in Missouri Valley Conference history to win the tournament title both as a player and a coach. And the throwaway by the big guy, O'Brien. Now, one thing we've seen, Clark Kellogg, in the games of this tournament, and it's been predictable, that's the way these contentious teams in this league have worked, it's defensive-oriented.
It very much is, Dick. Both of these teams and throughout the league, they really hang their hat on what they do defensively. There's Ruffin with the pilfer. Let's see if he gets points. He does.
6-2 on cue. Defense leads to a score.
That's what Bradley can do, though. Because they're a team that is able to defend and rebound, they can spurt out on you in transition. And I think it's going to be important for them to do that today, Dick, against a tough half-court defense of the Salukis. Get some easy scores in transition.
Leading scorer for Southern Illinois, Jamaal Tatum, unable to hit his first attempt. Here come the Braves with a four-point lead. Tony Bennett. Outside to Somerville, the big guy likes to shoot, and it takes more three-point attempts from outside than any of the Braves. Here's Mullins on that sore ankle. Inside to the 6'7 Falker, and he can't connect. Somerville clears. Somerville and O'Brien, each with a double-double in the victory against Wichita State, the conference champions, yesterday.
They both had 17 points and combined for 24 rebounds between the two of them. Zach Andrews on
just
the floor.
Just in the game, yeah.
He replaced O'Brien, who picked up a cheap over-the-back foul call. But Andrews, O'Brien at the scorer's table now, Dick, about to check back in, I think.
Andrews, 6'8 junior, and it's Mullins favoring that sore ankle as he walks to the bench. Well, that's not good news for Southern Illinois. He was the freshman player of the year in the Missouri Valley. He twisted it, making a critical shot in overtime yesterday. So the early going, it's the Bradley Braves leading 6-2 over Southern Illinois. Well, Clark, as we look at this Missouri Valley Conference, one thing that jumps out at you, the depth of outstanding teams. Look at those winning records of the top six teams in the Valley. That's why some feel they might get six invitations to the Big Dance. Some others say maybe only three.
Yeah, I think somewhere between four and six is a realistic number. And when you look at the quality of these teams in this league, they all will be in the discussion. I think all six of these teams will be on the at-large board in that NCAA selection room.
So we're underway here in St. Louis, 6-2. Bradley, let's go to Great Gumbel in New York.
Villanova leading it by 8. We'll keep you updated on that game. Let's send you back to St. Louis. Bradley and SIU, Dick Enberg and Clark Kellogg.
Southern Illinois with the ball, trailing Bradley by 4. The freshman and the tenacious defender, Bryan Mullins, with that sore ankle now on the bench. Young up with a jumper. Rebound went to Matt Shaw, who was one of the stars in the overtime win yesterday for the Salukis. Shaw by Somerville to one hand the rebound. Understand that the freshman Bryan Mullins has gone to the locker room. They had that ankle, right ankle, heavily taped and trying to get him back in condition, but he was wincing in pain as he left. Somerville, a 24-year-old forward, and he draws the foul. Tony Young picks up his first foul. And to the line, Marcella Somerville, the heart and soul of this team, their hardest worker, according to Coach Jim Less. Leading score, 15 and a half a game. As you see, Randal Falker taking a breather. He's the man that is charged with trying to stop the 7-footer O'Brien defensively. Bradley opens up a quick 6-point lead. 5 minutes gone.
Full court pressure here by the Braves. Again, they've hung their hat on defense during this 7-game win streak, Dick, but they're also an explosive offensive team, the highest scoring team in the Missouri Valley Conference.
Southern Illinois, the stingiest, allowing the least points. There's a travel, as having trouble was Wesley Clemens as he received the ball. Third turnover. Look at the brackets that led to this championship. Wichita State, the number one seed, and Southern Illinois, number two. Well, those two semifinals, four terrific teams. It's hotly contested, and Bradley and Southern Illinois prevailing. Southern Illinois off to a cold start, made their first shot, and they missed their next five, and now the turnover off O'Brien.
Well, this young fella has tremendous promise, Dick, Patrick O'Brien. He's long, he's pretty athletic, he's increased his strength and stamina from a year ago. That time, though, he didn't catch the ball with two hands, and it led to a turnover. Tried to catch it with one.
Out of bounds to Southern Illinois as we look at Patrick O'Brien.
Well, you take, yeah, he's terrific, Dick, across the board statistically. You see him in the top 10 in three categories there in league play.
You see for the first time Lawrence right into the game. Shaw. This is their tallest player, Jamaal Foster, and outside is Tony Young to hit the prior, and for Southern Illinois, that was a two.
Get off of me!
Near steal by Clemens, and there's Lawrence Wright. He's come into every game and delivered a basket immediately, not successful on his first attempt. Around the perimeter, Southern Illinois, trailing 8-4. The 8 on the shot clock. He forced that one. Let it. Foster at 6'8 and clear the rebound. Tatum for 3. Foster tips it out, goes right back to Tatum. Clemens from the baseline over the top of the hole. Well, the shooting has not been terrific in this tournament by any team. The defense has been outstanding. Tony Bennett from the corner. Batted by O'Brien, cleared by Clemens.
I think some of the poor shooting, Dick, can be attributed to outstanding defense. The other part can be familiarity with your opponent. This is the third time that many of these teams have faced each other when you start the conference tournament. And the other part of it is just missed shots. Guys are anxious, they're rushing. When they do get good looks, because the defense has been tough in many cases, they're rushing their shots and not making them.
2-for-10, Southern Illinois from the floor here to start the game. Trailing 8-4, down to 6 seconds on the shot clock. Shaw with 2, they got to hurry and do. Tatum over the top and clock violation. Bradley goes the other way. Lowry not happy with that trip down court.
Well, one of the things Southern Illinois wants to do is grind the shot clock. They want to absolutely take 25 to 30 seconds of time off that shot clock and wear the other team down with their offense, patient offense, and then what they do defensively in the man-to-man.
You forget the fact that you can play that tenacious defense and really wear down an opponent, but by really working the ball on the offensive end and stretching that 35 seconds, you tire your opponents as well. Not O'Brien, when you can come in close like that and slam it down. He has 6 points early. And a foul.
Anytime you get dribble penetration, defenders have to collapse. And Franklin finds O'Brien, and that's a hoop and a foul.
8 minutes into this first half. It's Bradley 10-4. We go to New York.
Dick and Clark.
Welcome back to St. Louis. Dick Enberg, Clark Kellogg, the Missouri Valley Conference championship game. And it's Bradley jumping in front 10-4 as Southern Illinois only 4 points in the first 8 minutes. And here is Patrick O'Brien, the big center at 7 feet tall out of the suburbs of Minneapolis, Blaine, Minnesota. Went to the Pete Newell Big Man School in Las Vegas last summer to polish his skills. And you like the potential of this young guy.
I really do. I like his length. His hands are pretty good. He's starting to get stronger and able to sustain his effort better. And the one thing I really love about him, Dick, in talking to Chris Lowry yesterday, I'm sorry, Jim Les yesterday, he talked about his coachability, his willingness to do the work, and he wants to be an excellent player.
Yeah, there's nice things to hear about this young man. Southern Illinois, only one field goal the last 7 minutes plus. Here's the man that can light it up from outside, Tatum. He pulls up inside and hits it cleanly. Tatum's first basket. Will Franklin, number 4 in the game for the first time for Bradley. Why on the outside. Land up on top, and then he'll work his way inside. Along the baseline, Franklin, and that sets up the jumper on the outside by Lawrence Wright. He's short on that one. Misses his first two attempts off the bench. Top number 6 man in the league. Welcome those of you that have watched Villanova defeat Syracuse, and that's Jamaal Tatum for Southern Illinois. He's hit back-to-back baskets, and Southern Illinois pulls to within 2, 11-9. Bradley and Red in the lead, have led since the opening bucket. We're in St. Louis for the Missouri Valley Conference Championship game presented by State Farm. Oh my, O'Brien, the seven-footer up high to wrap it in with one hand. He has 8 points, 9 points now to lead all scorers. As we approach the midpoint of this opening half, Southern Illinois, the number two seeds, and Bradley, the number five, but Bradley, the hot team with seven consecutive games. They were 13-9 and now moves to 20-9 on the season and in contention for an NCAA berth. This is Clemens to Tatum, down to six in the shot clock. That's the Southern Illinois style. They work it down to the final second. They got to hurry now. Clemens, and he misses the three-pointer. Rebound by Twy. O'Brien is 4 for 4 for Bradley. He's the man with the ball. The rest of the team 1 for 8, and that's the third turnover charge to O'Brien. You look at the starting lineups, O'Brien and Somerville, the veterans, they got some size inside with Ruffin led the league in assists. Twy and Bennett, Shaw, star yesterday. Falker, their top rebounder. Young, the point guard, with Mullins, the freshman, an injured ankle, and he has not returned. He started the game, played a couple of minutes, and then limped off. He hurt himself in the overtime win yesterday.
And they'll really miss his presence, Dick, because he's a stabilizer. He's a guy who sets other people up. And he's one of the best pilferers in the country. Ranked ninth in the country in steals, averaging close to 3 steals a game.
Yeah, led the conference with 89 steals. Here's Shaw. And old Bryant with a block. Shaw gets it back for Tatum, a 3-point attempt. Down the bottom of the well, and it's 13-12. 7 points for Tatum and the turnover. Largest crowds in the history of the conference championship here in the Valley. Nearly 18,000 for the semis yesterday. That's 2,000 more than any Missouri Valley Conference tournament game.
I think that's indicative of the people of St. Louis, the fans of these universities, and the quality of play across this conference, Dick.
And a 5-second violation against Southern Illinois. So they get the turnover and then give it right back, as Jim Liss on the bench for the Bradley Braves. Chris Lowry, young 33-year-old, the seventh youngest head coach in Division I for Southern Illinois.
And already he's had 2 20-win seasons in 2 years as a head coach.
His mentor, Bruce Weber, he coached under Weber at Southern Illinois, and then when Weber went on to Illinois with great success, Lowry joined him, and then 2 years ago took over the reins of this program. He was a point guard, graduated in 95. As a Salukis.
Boy, and Dick, you look at his coaching resume, even though he's very, very young, he has a lot of work under his belt before getting this head coaching job here at Southern Illinois.
Marcellus Somerville barrels his way underneath and draws the foul from Clemens. Missouri Valley Conference, the reason they're excited and they're looking for several entries in the NCAA Big Dance. They are ahead of Pac-10 in the RPI conference rankings.
Well, you look at some of their non-conference wins and the quality of play within the league. Certainly the 6 teams we highlighted just a moment ago will all be strongly talked about in terms of whether or not they are deserving of at-large bids. I think you're going to end up with somewhere between 3 and 5 teams out of this league, depending on what goes on elsewhere, Dick, being part of the field of 65.
They're going to be in a lot of conversation, aren't they? Somerville with 4 consecutive free throws. Those are the only points he has, and it's a 3-point lead for Bradley. Young, the point guard. Here's Tatum, the score. He scored the last 8 points for Southern Illinois. Good pass inside to Falker. Randall Falker, he's from St. Louis, went to Gateway Tech High School here. And he gets to the line as well. Foul is on Somerville, his first.
Penetration. O'Brien comes to help. Actually, that was O'Brien coming out to help. And when he's not at the rim, there's an opportunity to finish at the basket.
Randall.
O'Brien leaves Falker. And as he does, the rotation is late getting there. And Falker able to get the dunk down.
Shaw got a hand on it, but couldn't get it to a teammate, and that'll be a foul in the backcourt on Clemens. As slipping down was Daniel Ruffin. Some of the fans thought Ruffin went down on his own accord.
Well, he was helped just a little bit by Clemens. He did slip, but there was a nudge there. So a good call.
Second foul on Wesley Clemens from Indianapolis. A terrific leaper at 6'3". He's going to come out as Austin Brooks, a walk-on from Evansville, Indiana. A senior at 5'10", replaces him. 1-point lead, Bradley and the ball. Ruffin, who led the league with 5.5 assists a game, well guarded by Brooks. Somerville fires the three, rattles out. That'll be a foul as Wright crashes in for the rebound and picks up the foul for Bradley. And with that, we have a break in the action. 7:47 remaining in this opening half. The Valley Championship Tournament, and it's Bradley by one.
Coverage of the Missouri Valley Conference Championship presented by State Farm is sponsored by the United States Marine Corps. The few, the proud, the Marines. Singular, raising the bar. And by State Farm. For great service and great rates, nobody takes care of you like State Farm.
Along the banks of the Mississippi, Arch Madness here in St. Louis. And here's a look at our game summary with Bradley leading by one, both teams shooting mid-30s and front court points, and that's where Bradley, with Patrick O'Brien's 9 points, have shown their strength.
That's their advantage, the size inside. And O'Brien off to a terrific start, but the Salukis will counter that with the perimeter play. 10 points of their 14 have been produced by the backcourt.
Southern Illinois has not led. 7-point lead for Bradley, the biggest of this first half. At the 7.5-minute mark, as Tatum gives the Salukis their first advantage at 17-15. Now make that a 2, 16-15. Tatum now with 10 points to lead all scorers, and there's a great pass right at the level of the rim. Tony Bennett to O'Brien, and O'Brien has 11 points to lead all scorers. It's back and forth now with Bradley in front by one. And a whistle on the baseline was Tatum. Turns it over to the Bradley Braves.
Take a look at Falker. He's going to trip over the foot of Patrick O'Brien. And that frees up Tony Bennett to have an easy pass at the rim for Patrick O'Brien. But Falker, the guy defending O'Brien, was on the ground. So an easy score for Patrick inside.
O'Brien is 5 for 5, but you do get a pretty high percentage shot, don't you, when you're in like that?
That's like rolling in those 2-foot putts. You should make a high percentage of
it. Good ball movement. They get it into the big fella. He's got 5 inches on the man trying to guard him and triples it off the rim, batted out of bounds by Southern Illinois. A reminder, the countdown to the tournament is on, and the CBS Sports Line is your destination for complete coverage. Get the latest news and exclusive video at CBSSportsLine.com. And to Will Franklin, the junior from Houston. O'Brien hands it off to Ruffin. Ruffin, the 5'10 sophomore from Peoria, sets it up. Tony Bennett, a Chicagoan. Two Illinois teams here for the final of the Missouri Valley Championship Tournament. High pass and good work by O'Brien to just barely get the right hand on it and tip it back to himself. He has 13. He's averaging 13 on the season.
Yeah, the Braves doing a nice job really trying to go at Randal Falker inside. Southern Illinois wants to pressure the ball, but they're not disrupting the perimeter passers for Bradley. And as a result, Patrick O'Brien able to take full advantage of his size in the paint.
Saw the points in the paint. Again, Southern Illinois running the clock down at 35 seconds, and the shot not there. Falker has it taken away by the taller O'Brien. 3-point lead, Bradley with the ball. Way outside Somerville, and he bangs in a long three. Marcellus Somerville now with 6. The Braves and their fans cheer a six-point lead. We've got 5:21 left in the half.
Bradley on top by six, and the big reason why, number 13, Patrick O'Brien, having his way, he's already matched his season's average with 13 here in the first 15 minutes of this one, and he's getting everything he wants around the rim. He's just too tall, has excellent hand, and is doing what he does best, put the ball in the hole inside.
6 for 7 is O'Brien, the tallest starter in the Missouri Valley Conference on the year, listed as a 7-footer. Tatum pulls up. That would have been a 2. And a good rebound taken by Tony Bennett. 7-0 run for the Braves of Bradley to lead it at 22-16. So far, Southern Illinois unable to defend the big guy. And there he is with position on Falker again. And he turns it over. That has been the only weakness from his contribution. He's had 3 or 4 turnovers. Tomorrow, CBS Monday. Don't miss an all-new night of comedy, King of Queens, I Met Your Mother, How I Met Your Mother, 2.5 Men, Courting Alex, followed by a new CSI Miami, and of course, Dave. Tomorrow on CBS, America's number one network. Back to the defense of Southern Illinois. Now goes on offense. Chris Lowry does not use his own defense, so they're not going to collapse in and use that tactic defensively to try to stop O'Brien.
What they want to do, Dick, is be disruptive on the perimeter. They've yet to be able to do that. They want to be irritants to the ball handlers and passers, but so far, Bradley has been able to make passes inside to O'Brien with ease.
Well, Jim Less wanted a 5-second count as Falker was trapped by O'Brien's defense. Young, no foul. And no basket for Young. He gets it back, and O'Brien gets a piece of it. And that'll be goaltending. Austin Brooks credited with his first basket of the game. He has only 19 points all season in 28 games, Brooks.
Nice job there by Patrick O'Brien. Leads the league in block shots, defensive player of the year in the Missouri Valley Conference. But that one clearly was on its way down.
O'Brien averaging 3.1 blocks per game to lead all conference players.
He's doing that, Dick, in about 25 minutes per game. So as he continues to get stronger, his minutes will increase, so will his production.
O'Brien denied, but he was fouled and comes away with a pained expression. Might have been slapped in the face. 4 minutes to go, 4-point lead.
There you see what we were talking about with Patrick O'Brien, only a sophomore. Top 2 in blocks and rebounds, and there you see his point total.
Tony Young trying to help out the guard, picked up the foul, his second. O'Brien misses the free throw. Not a bad free throw shooter, around 69% on the season.
And that too will get better. That will be an opportunity for him to add 5 to 7 points a game to his point total and his team's. Because as he gets stronger, he'll be able to post up, hold his position, and draw fouls.
And Jim Less, his coach, says he thinks he can play at 270 very easily. He's about 250 right now.
Got a frame that can handle some additional weight put on in the right way.
Misses the 2 free throws, so the Salukis with the ball trailing by 4. And they've never led in this first half as Shaw goes up with a jumper and lines it home. Shaw, who on his birthday yesterday, scored 15 and leading the Salukis in that overtime win against Northern Iowa.
Well, Chris Lowry would like to see him be a little more aggressive offensively because he's a capable shooter out to 17 or 18 feet. Actually, in conference play, Dick, he's one of the best three-point shooters in the Missouri Valley Conference, was Matt Schill.
Down to 8 seconds on the shot clock for Bradley as the Southern Illinois defense digs in. Tony Bennett way off the mark, and Falker pulls in the rebound. Southern Illinois did lead once at 16-15. They have a chance on a 3-pointer to take the lead here at the 2:45 mark. They'll run down some clock. And quickly inside to Falker, unable to score, but saves the ball for a moment. And here comes Franklin the other way for Bradley. 3-on-2, all the way to the basket. Will Franklin with his first contribution offensively.
Well, that was made possible because the guy on the left lane ran the floor, forcing the defender to react to him, and that opened things up right down the middle for Franklin. That's why you have to run the lanes wide to allow your guy in the middle to have options.
Unlock the door for him right down the middle. Ooh, another steal by Franklin. He's moved into that backup point guard position with his outstanding play in the second half of the year. Tatum. Great leaping by Clemens, but the scramble, and it goes to Bradley. 2-on-2 for Franklin. And the turnover is Somerville unable to control. Sixth turnover for Bradley. 1:44 before the intermission. The Braves by four. And welcome back to St. Louis. A reminder coming up on Singular at the Half. Join Greg Gumbel and Seth Davis for all the scores and highlights, plus the latest tournament news, a Singular Naismith watch update as well, all coming up on Singular at the Half. One of the stories, the Ohio State Buckeyes clinched the Big Ten title with another impressive win today over Purdue.
Yes, sir. Congratulations to the Buckeyes. This scarlet and gray heart of mine beating a little stronger and happier as a result.
Oh, the Wolverine fans are so happy for you. 45 seconds to go. 1-point game. And this is just as expected. It's been so contentious, competitive throughout the Missouri Valley. And there's another steal. Same guy, Tony Young. And it'll be Southern Illinois with a chance for the lead here as the final seconds tick away in the first half. About a 2.5-second difference between the clocks.
Well, what a victory this would be if Southern Illinois could get to the locker room up one or two. It seems as though they should be down by so much more, but turnovers and then second shot opportunities for Southern Illinois have allowed them to stay tight.
With 4 seconds, with 3 seconds, it's Tatum off the mark. Tatum gets it back at the buzzer. That was the buzzer for the shot clock. And without any contact with the rim, that'll be two Bradley, and they might adjust the clock as well.
They should.
Ran off another full second, I believe.
Mm-hmm. Well, we'll take a look. Keep an eye on the shot clock right in there, and let's see what this says here.
1.4 showing on the clock now.
About 2.3 is what you called, Dick. You said it prior to them getting the shot off, about a 2-plus-second differential between game and shot clock, so that's plenty of time with a long pass to have a chance to dribble into something.
Well, especially with that big guy O'Brien. You camp him down there. If nothing else, fire it up toward the rim. See if he can get it.
Well, the official's taking a look at the monitor. And I'm sure they will add at least 0.9 seconds to what we see on our screen right now. But boy, Southern Illinois has been able to get second shot opportunities. Bradley has committed 7 or 8 turnovers. And as a result, in a game where Bradley has scored a little easier, they haven't been able to pull away.
Now, if you're exactly right as you sit here. If you weren't looking at the scoreboard, you just have the sense that Bradley should be ahead by
right.
7-8 points.
That's right.
Jim Less, a most interesting career. He had a modest professional career in the NBA for 7 years, 9 years as a pro. The long pass, and Wright will have to hurry at the buzzer. And it would have counted, I believe, had it gone in. He just did release it in time. That's the end of the first half. With the score, the Bradley Braves 24, the Southern Illinois Salukis 23. We'll send you to New York right after this message. You're watching NCAA basketball on CBS. We're back with Arch Madness in St. Louis, the Missouri Valley Conference Championship presented by State Farm. True to the theme on the season, defense prevails, and Bradley leads Southern Illinois 24-23. We'll be back with the second half after this message and a word from your local station. You're watching NCAA basketball on CBS, America's number one network. Getting ready for the second half. Bradley leading for the first time at halftime in tournament play, 24-23. Let's take a look at our State Farm first half statistics. Anything jump out at you other than the front court dominance of the Braves?
No, not really. The backcourt points from Southern Illinois, good. Turnovers, obviously, a big deal, as you mentioned, Dick.
And the backcourt, it just as predicted, the backcourt's 17 of the 23 points for Southern Illinois backcourt and 20 of the 24 for Bradley from the front court.
Exactly. One thing that does step out at me a little bit, we didn't see it there, was the fact that Southern Illinois able to pick up 8 offensive rebounds against a team that's much bigger than they are.
O'Brien leading Bradley with 13 and Tatum with 10 as Falker around O'Brien and can't follow it. Missed, and then the tip was close. But O'Brien just so intimidating with his size and length.
He's got a great wingspan, and you have to think about him when you go in there trying to score in the paint.
And 9 fouls called total in that first half. So it's a defensive-oriented league and a slow whistle here in the Missouri Valley. Marcellus unable to hit. Somerville and a whistle underneath. And that could be against O'Brien. It's his second.
Well, he made 6 of 7 shots in the first half because he was making buckets like that. One dunk, make it 2 dunks. How about 3 dunks?
Back to live action. This is Bryan Mullins handling the ball. He's going to try to play here in the second half. Got in only 4 minutes of the first half before he limped off. And there is Falker driving and giving O'Brien to taste of his own medicine. 25-24, Southern Illinois takes the lead here early in the second half. Falker pulls in the rebound, and the fans for Bradley felt that the whistle should have blown there. See how well Mullins can play. He's such a tenacious defender, but on that gimpy ankle, he's unable to give that 100% that we saw in the earlier 2 games. Here he is. Yeah, the tying shot at regulation yesterday. Down to 8 again. Falker over O'Brien, can't hit. And here comes Bradley the other way.
Last 2 possessions, Southern Illinois has tried to attack O'Brien through Falker because of the 2 fouls that Patrick O'Brien has.
As O'Brien tried to flip and goes through the hands of Somerville. Now back inside to Somerville. Muscular 6'7". Forces the shot. O'Brien off several hands. The last touch by Young of Southern Illinois. Randal Falker, he plays bigger than 6'7", doesn't he?
Well, he did a nice job there sealing and walking O'Brien up the lane so he could have freedom on the backside. And then good activity as he's able to block the shot and retain possession. He had a big game in one of the meetings against Bradley earlier this year, 24 points.
Got 6 points today and 7 rebounds, Falker. Down to 6. Bradley's going to have to hurry. 3. And from way outside, Franklin unable to hit the 3-pointer.
Boy, Dick, Southern Illinois doing a nice job on the glass. Offensive rebounds at their end, but then 1 shot and only 1 shot for Bradley at their defensive end.
And you take away the easy dunks by O'Brien, and it really has been a very successful Lowry defense. And Matt Shaw gets the short jumper for only his 4th point of the game. Shaw is averaging 10 on the season. And Southern Illinois and their fans on their feet. They lead by 3. Biggest lead of the game for Southern Illinois, 27-24, 3 minutes into the second half. And near the end of today's game, we'll select once again a Chevrolet player of the game from each team. Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund. America's brand supports America's best. Chevy, an American revolution. Southern Illinois in the 2 halves with an 11-2 run. And Bradley, no points in the last 5:40. Led by 7 in the first half, did the Braves with the ball. Somerville from the corner can't hit the 3. Falker up high and able to get it off to Mullins on the save.
Well, the defensive board work by Southern Illinois has been splendid so far. And then they get into their mode of grinding you out offensively.
Inside to Falker, O'Brien. A lot of contact, and Falker, in trying to maneuver, took too many. And the defense of O'Brien, another dividend for Bradley.
One of the things you want to do if you're going to attack a shot blocker, Dick, you don't want to play with your back to him all the time. You want to turn and face him and go at him and use some of your offensive repertoire that way, because when you put your back to him, you really give him the advantage defensively.
And if you're front to front, then you're going to get the foul call.
Exactly. You'll have a better chance to draw that foul.
Well, how about the Salukis as they look for a place in the big dance? An RPI of 35. They've won 21. That's the fifth straight year that the Salukis have a 20-win season.
Yeah. And you know what? One of the differentiating things is you compare this kind of resume to teams like Colorado, Texas A&M, Houston, maybe Syracuse, California, is what have you done outside of your league? You saw all of those key wins, Dick, were within conference play. Wichita State, Creighton, Northern Iowa, Missouri State. Those are good wins, but what have you been able to do outside of your conference? What kind of wins have you had outside of your league? And that, to me, will be one of the differentiating factors for teams like Southern Illinois.
Will Franklin missing both free throw attempts, and Falker flashing in, but O'Brien from behind able to make the block, and it's out of bounds to Bradley. And O'Brien's defensive and offensive presence outstanding throughout the course of this game.
Terrific time, and he came over the back just a touch, but he got an awful lot of the basketball there. Well, I like his activity, don't you?
That's his third block, and he's averaged more than three on the season.
Somebody else is going to have to step up and produce some points for the Braves. O'Brien can dominate, but this guy needs to get going.
Ooh, he misses the easy. That was just a drop over. But Bradley, a second chance. Right from the side is short. And Falker rips down another rebound, and he's moving in on double figures as he clears the boards. O'Brien is 6 for 7. The rest of the Bradley team is 3 for 20. Mullins maneuvering. Here's their top scorer, Tatum. Walked by Franklin. Oh, he splits the defense and up with a 10-footer. But again, O'Brien made him pull up on the shot. And then Franklin turns down the three. Bennett in the corner. And he's way off the mark. Mullins embraces the rebound. 7-minute drought for Bradley. They've missed 9 shots in a row. And yet the score is 27-24. First to 50 wins. That's often the case here in the Valley.
It certainly has been.
They are under 10 again before attempting the shot. Down to 5. Tatum double teamed, gets it to the corner to Shaw, and he misses the three. And that's one of the reasons why the scores are so low. They chew up a lot of clock,
that's right.
And then they are forced to make a tough shot. 0-for-8 and 2-for-8 this half.
But you know, Southern Illinois doesn't mind playing that way, Dick. That's who they are. And there's a defensive play by Falker. He fronted the low post. The passer assumed that he could get it over the top, and it didn't happen.
Yeah, he at 6'7", plays a lot taller. Kid from St. Louis, a lot of family and friends here to cheer him. That's inspiration. Time called, and State Farm will present now the drive to 65. The Missouri Valley Conference, nation's second oldest, has a fine history through the years. The Valley has produced great players. Oscar Robertson, Larry Bird at Indiana State. How about Hersey Hawkins at Bradley? And we've had some memorable upsets as well. How about Creighton beating Florida in the tournament 4 years ago? And this year it's no exception. Northern Iowa, some big scalps. Iowa, Bucknell, LSU. That's impressive when you talk about the committee thinking about selection Sunday. Indiana lost Indiana State. It was Evansville over Purdue. And Creighton defeated Nebraska.
Well, it goes back to the point I just made, Dick. What have you done out of your conference? You talk about Northern Iowa. That's a tournament resume there that says you're an at-large team. When you beat those kind of teams, the win against LSU was on the road. So, again, that's a differentiating factor that's going to separate some of these teams that are on the stoop but in the conversation for at-large bids.
The drive to 65 presented by State Farm. Falker inside. Does the basket count? Yes, it does. Able to use his body to ward off the taller Braves. And Randall Falker, both ends, has been a star in this second half. And we'll return to St. Louis after this message and a word from your local station. You're watching NCAA Basketball on CBS, America's number one network. Ice cold Bradley in Southern Illinois, biggest lead 29-24. We're in St. Louis, the Missouri Valley Conference Championship presented by State Farm. And who's in and who's out, who's playing home and when, get it first and get it fast with Greg Clark and company next Sunday, the NCAA Basketball Championship Selection Show live at 6 Eastern here on CBS, 3 o'clock in the West. And you can bet one thing, and you know every coach and every kid in the country boy, glued to the set next Sunday night.
Without question, Dick, looking forward to it as Falker doesn't cash in. But a second chance opportunity for Southern Illinois. See a little doubt creeping into the Bradley Braves, Dick. That last possession, they weren't quite together and cohesive defensively.
And there's Falker inside again and draws the foul from O'Brien. It is quick step, even though he's 7 inches shorter, able to get up, or 5 inches shorter, able to get up inside O'Brien.
Falker having some kind of game on his way to a double-double. Uses his body effectively there. Good timing on the block shot. Good movement without the ball. And he's taking it to Patrick O'Brien inside with force here in the second half.
And O'Brien now with 3 fouls, and he's going to come out as Lawrence Wright enters the game, a 6'4 senior. Top number 6 man, and O'Brien rests with 3. He's fouled out only once all year. Jim Les protects him quickly when he gets that 3rd foul. And here's Falk. He's missed 3 in a row and finally makes that one for his 9th point to go with 10 rebounds and a 6-point lead. And will Bradley ever score? They're approaching 9 minutes without a point.
Well, if it's going to happen, Tony Bennett has to get it going. Somerville, Marcellus has to find some offense.
Another turnover. And streaking down court is Clemens. He does not score. No basket on the follow. There was a foul. As they sort it out, we'll remind you with NCAA March Madness on demand, you can watch live tournament games outside your viewing area for free. Sign up for your free VIP pass now at ncaasports.com/MMOD. Foul was on Tony Bennett, his first. And Wesley Clemens at the line looking for his first point. Boy, the free throw shooting has not been good.
I mean, this could be an 8 or 9 point lead. I mean, Falker just missed 3 out of 4. Now Clemens misses the first of 2. And in a low possession game, these are what we call easy scoring opportunities that you need to cash in on.
2 for 6 as a team, Southern Illinois. Clemens, freshman from Indianapolis, has his first point and a 7-point lead. The score at the half, fans, was 24-23 Bradley, and they're still stuck on 24, and we've played 5 minutes and 35 seconds.
Well, it's just so hard to break their guards down off the dribble, Dick. Tatum, Young, although he's not on the floor right now, and even Mullins, who's out there on the gimpy ankles in pretty good solid position defensively.
6:35, and then you add the time in the first half, over 9 minutes now without a point for Bradley. Incredible.
Yeah, you need some kind of dribble penetration.
Tony Bennett has the quickness, but he comes inside to Wright. And Lawrence Wright, finally for Bradley, gets a score on the board here in the second half. It comes with under 13 minutes to play in the second half.
I think he's the guy they have to play through with this lineup on the floor, with O'Brien on the bench with 3 fouls. Somerville can get it going, but I think Wright has a more comfortable matchup.
Now the turnover by Tatum. There was no one there for him, and Franklin gets it off on the run to Bennett. He misses the short jumper, and who but Falker down quickly to hustle and get the rebound.
Well, he had 20 rebounds in 2 tournament games coming into today's game. 10 of those have been on the offensive glass. He's been a glass-eating machine here in this tournament.
He's got 12 today. And despite that horrendous drought for Bradley, they're still down by only 5. You figure they're going to have a run, don't
they? Right, exactly. They are a spurt team. But none of these teams run away and hide from one another.
Down to 5 on the shot clock. Mullins off that sore ankle, unable to push off. But there's Tatum to give Southern Illinois another chance.
Well, Shaw's got to look to take this one against a much smaller Daniel Ruffin.
11:47 left in the second half. The Valley Championship from St. Louis. The winner today earns an automatic berth in the big dance in Southern Illinois. 11 years since they won the tournament championship. Have the lead. And well, Clark, a lot of talk and all the evidence isn't in. I know it's tough to really make a lot of predictions, but here's six teams that have numbers that are worthy of consideration.
Without question, strong consideration when you just look at how many wins these teams have and their RPI. But you also have to factor in, which we can't completely do here on the graphic, is wins on the road, non-league schedule, and what goes on elsewhere. But you're right, these teams all will get strong consideration just based on what they've been able to do thus far.
But the certainty is the winner today. They're in.
That's right. And the other factor is the last 10 games, how you played in that stretch. And Falker continues to do work inside.
Boy, he's had an MVP game, 33-26. And with O'Brien on the bench with three fouls, Falker now in a double-double, 11 points and a dozen rebounds. Right, averaging 10 a game off the bench, number 22. He finally ended the drought for Bradley. Franklin resets, down to 8 seconds on the shot clock. Both ends, Southern Illinois chewing up time. Franklin can't hit. Falker got a piece of it, but it was Shaw rips it in. And here come the Salukis.
Not only are they chewing up time, they're chewing up every single defensive rebound.
And O'Brien's off the bench and at the scorer's table. He'll come in on the next break. Shaw for three. Big, big for Southern Illinois Salukis. They lead by 10. 7 points for Shaw. This smothering defense of Southern Illinois, and another turnover is Shaw. A good anticipation, cuts in front of the receiver. You know where they want to go. This man, Falker, he is hot. A dozen lead and a turnover. Everything going to Southern Illinois at both ends of the court. At the midpoint of this second half, the Salukis by a dozen. Randal, Falker Day in St. Louis. Bradley fans around the country must be shaking their hands. Hard to believe in 10 minutes of this second half, Bradley has scored 2 points. And it's Southern Illinois and their young coach Chris Lowry with a 22-4 run to take the lead, 38-26. And after that last basket and hurrying the ball in play, Bradley threw it away. Now they've got the big guy back in there, Patrick O'Brien. But he is caught on the backside as Shaw breaks in for an easy two. Southern Illinois trying to make it 5 straight trips to the NCAA tournament. At large the last 4 years. Somerville, a three. Just one fall for Bradley. Kind of thought they'd take some time and get it into O'Brien, though. But he's back on the court.
But they've lost their composure a bit here. You're seeing, Dick, a team that's been to 4 straight NCAA tournaments, although the makeup of the team is a little different. Their experience, their expectations, their focus, their intensity, their tenacity, all of that coming into play here. Here you take a look at Matt Shaw. The ball's right here. He's just going to back cut and get right to the rim. Inexcusable defensively. But he beat Somerville, no help, and that's a flush. But again, I think that points out the lack of cohesiveness at the defensive end. And that's what Southern Illinois likes to do to you. They want to frustrate you by grinding you out and making it tough for you.
Well, Tatum and the Southern Illinois doing this all without their star shooter. Tatum making much of a contribution. And the ball just seems to find Southern Illinois, doesn't it?
Yep.
That last foul, by the way, was on Somerville, his first. Shaw holding his face and took a bump in the mouth in that last exchange.
Well, We're going to find out what kind of fight the Braves have left in them, because it's going to take a Herculean effort to scratch and claw themselves back into this game against the kind of team that the Salukis are.
Yeah, Tatum holds the ball. He heard the whistle as Shaw goes to the sidelines holding his mouth, appears to be bleeding. Nose, I guess, is where he took the clip. Coach Chris Lowry and this Southern Illinois team can be very strong again next year. They lose only two players, two seniors that are walk-ons.
That's right.
All the starters will be back. And his team doing it on defense, and that's been the MO for the Southern Illinois team. It was under Bruce Weber when he was here. Now the 2 years of Chris Lowry, and what a job. His team won 27 last year, 21 this year. How about that? 48 wins, this 33-year-old coach.
Well, I was really impressed with him when we had a chance to visit with him yesterday, Dick. Very poised, very focused and organized. Look at the defense by the Salukis. You just don't get any easy penetration, and I think Bradley has settled too much for not trying to penetrate. The guards have not probed enough to try to stick it in there and put the Salukis a little more on their heels defensively. Much easier said than done.
Now with a cushion of a 14-point lead, Southern Illinois, and Tatum hasn't scored a point in this second half. Young from way downtown, not there, but look who hustles to get the rebound. Again, the white jerseys, and it's Clemens off to Falker, who is I'm going to just come out here for a while, give you a little screen, and then look for me down in the hole. But first, get the clock down about 5 seconds.
There you go.
Too much time here. At 15 right now. Oh, good steal there by Bennett. And Tony Bennett. And Bradley still can't sing in Bennett. This foul.
Well, they're letting him play. There was a bump there, no whistle. And Bennett able to come up with the loose ball.
That is the fourth foul, though, Clark Kellogg, on Tony Young, their point guard for Southern Illinois. At the line, Tony Bennett, the energizer on this Bradley team. He's out of Chicago Westinghouse High School, averaging 11 a game. No points today. There's his first. A reminder, tonight on 60 Minutes, he's called the Prince of Pot. And confesses that his marijuana business is very large. So why isn't he in jail? 60 Minutes tonight will tell you. Tony Young takes the seat with four fouls and only one out of two for Tony Bennett.
Bradley has been unable to really disrupt the Salukis in their offense. I would pressure Mullins. Of him being on a gimpy ankle, I would really try to get up into him and make him turn and really work with the basketball.
And chewing up the time. Clock is in the favor of the Southern Illinois Salukis as Falker, a rare mistake for him, threw it away. Franklin to the other end has it batted away, and Mullins able to flip it ahead to Falker. And timeout call by Chris Lowry to save a 5 second penalty. He didn't like to use it, but wanted to save the ball. Timeout with 7:26 left. Oh boy, the balding bomber from Ball State, David Letterman. What a lineup he has this week. Listen, Harrison Ford, Ben Roethlisberger, Beyonce, Jimmy Fallon, and Stupid Human Tricks all this week on The Letterman Show, CBS, America's number one network. Now, Patrick O'Brien, he has been the offense for Bradley, 13 of their 24 points. Bradley in 12 and a half minutes of the second half with only 3 points.
And O'Brien sat a good portion of this second half so far with 3 fouls.
And that's where the game really turned for Southern.
It sure did.
Because this man, Falker, then had a field day. Now with O'Brien in there, a little different. Enough to change the shot there as Falker misses. This is White. He'll take the three. Bennett in the wow. Big boys. Did he get in the air?
He sure did.
Tony Bennett cuts the lead to 11. His first basket of the game. That gives the Bradley fans a taste of hope. Down to 6.5 minutes. Tatum weaves his way inside. And they'll tie it up with the arrow pointing to Bradley. Time working against the Bradley Braves. 6:28 to go. Southern Illinois by 11. Back with our game summary, and look at the 3-point field goals, and it would appear the Braves are going to have to get some trays
right. To
pull up, and they're 1 for 14. O'Brien and Falker, the two big men, 13 points each. And our congratulations to the teams in Belmont, Murray State, Winthrop, and Penn. And another game concurrent with this one in the Southern Conference, Davidson with a huge lead against Tennessee Chattanooga. Appears Davidson will make it into the big dance
they
as well.
They certainly will. And five teams of 65 eventually that will be part of the bracket. This winner will be amongst those five. Actually, it'll move the number to 6 by the time this game is over.
It's a big possession for Bradley.
Yeah, they need to score. They need to find a way to get some scores. A bucket here would cut it to single digits.
And a 3 would make it even more interesting as O'Brien inside looks for help over Falker. Can't hit. Lemons in to grab the rebound for Southern Illinois. 6 minutes to go. Ben from Peoria puzzled by this Southern Illinois defense. Tatum. Oh, Falker almost with a one-handed tip. Loose ball right back to Tatum. Fill a new clock. They can run it down to almost 5 minutes to go on this possession. Randal Falker has been most impressive, this, especially the second half.
Yeah, he's been terrific. Absolutely terrific.
Foul inside on Tony Bennett. His second personal. Falker, an outstanding student. Tatum at 3.7 with the ball now, academic All-America candidate.
Yeah, delightful young fellow too. We had a chance to visit with him yesterday. He's got 4 or 5 irons in the fire. He's a businessman and student.
T-shirt business. He's the one who suggested they wear the black shoes and black socks for the tournament. And there he is on cue, and Falker follows. Well, you may not have known much about Randal Falker, this sophomore from St. Louis, but he's putting on a show for the tournament title for the Southern Illinois Salukis. 15 and 14 points and rebounds. O'Brien, and that'll count.
Finally, they get it into him in good scoring position here in the second half. Penetration breaks down the defense. Offensive rebound lanes available. That's the 15th offensive rebound for Southern Illinois. And we talked about their lack of size, and they've won the rebounding battle thus far. And then O'Brien showing you that tremendous potential, the nice soft touch, and the long wingspan on that jump hook.
1 for 3 from the line until that shot, and he converts the 3-point play, and it's a 10-point game. Is there time left for Bradley, especially the way Southern Illinois able to work the clock, and the Braves are in a position where they almost have to force a turnover?
Or if they don't get a turnover and get a missed shot, they need to come up with a defensive board.
Almost a steal by Tony Bennett.
They've gotten hurt all game long, Dick, on the offensive glass.
16 seconds left on the shot clock.
You see, with the 3-point shot, there's plenty of time if you get stops and rebounds.
Lots of contact, no whistle. Falker takes it inside, loses the ball. Franklin picks it up for Bradley. And Shaw, what a play by Shaw! And he draws the foul from Somerville. There was the turnover, and somehow Shaw leaped into the passing lane and tipped the ball to himself and drew the foul.
Well, they're letting him bang and thump and bump here. A lot of contact going uncalled, and there's a tough, perhaps even a frustration foul on Marcellus Somerville. Will Franklin was in a tough spot because he was losing his balance as he tried to make that pass, and therefore he couldn't get enough on it. And give excellent credit Well, credit for excellent hustle to Matt Shaw. He didn't give up on that play.
Sophomore from Centralia, Illinois. An excellent free throw shooter at nearly 79%. That's his 10th point of the game. He had 15 yesterday against Northern Iowa. His nose plugged after taking an elbow earlier in the second half. He looks like a fighter, doesn't he?
He sure does. Well, he's been very productive the last couple of games.
Extends Southern Illinois' lead back to a dozen with 4:12 left.
Well, that was a big turnaround there, Dick. Bradley had forced a turnover and then gave it right back.
Somerville with a long three, but fading away, and Falker one hands the rebound. 16 rebounds now for him.
Well, these Salukis play with such grit. Boy, they make it tough for you. They're physical, and as you get into tournament play, where the officials allow you to play a little more, it suits their style perfectly.
They love them to play here in the Valley, don't they?
Yeah.
Well, here they are again. They've used up 30 of the 35. Tatum with two. Shaw at the buzzer. Oh, that should be a hold on Tatum. He pulled down Bennett by the jersey, and that is a foul. They do call those.
That's only the 15th foul on the Salukis, though.
Southern Illinois, Chris Lowry's Salukis in command by 12. This crowd of 14,000 just silent as they watch this young lady being attended to, and she has moved her legs, moved her arms, and the crowd applauding to that. It's a long distance, and you see she was the top of the pyramid.
Right in there, folks. Oh. And terrible spill here, Dick.
One of the spotters able to get just a piece of her so that she didn't fall full force to the floor. But they'll take every precaution, and this is, you know, it's always a concern, especially the loved ones of this young woman. But it did appear that she had full movement of all of her extremities. And they just want to make certain there isn't any fracture of any kind. And some prayers are being sent out, as one might imagine. Christy Yamaoka, the young cheerleader that took the fall.
You can see her eyes are open and she's batting her eyelids. And we did see some movement, as you mentioned, Dick, but that's always a downer to see something like that.
And again, unlike 20, 30 years ago, and medical attention trainers, they're there immediately to provide the proper first aid. There she is with a wave of the hand.
Both hands.
Oh, my.
Well, that's an encouraging sign. And she's doing the cheer.
Look at this. When she offered her first movement, I've got three daughters. Typical first thing she did, make sure her skirt was properly placed as she was being placed on the stretcher. Wow. Good luck to that young lady. And it just concerns me when you watch it game after game after game. They do such incredible tricks, and the pyramids become three people high.
Yeah, sometimes they push that envelope just a little much.
Both teams waiting patiently, and now action continues. Bradley's ball trailing Southern Illinois 44-32, 3:20 to go. Bradley now have to up tempo it. They need points, and Bennett tries a three and hits it. Tony Bennett cuts it to 9. That's his 6th point of the game. Now full court pressure, Bradley. No whistle, but the turnover. Another three by Bennett. Oh my! 6 points in 10 seconds. 44-38. Boy, they let him get away with some grabbing on that.
That's been the case all game, Dick. So
they're consistent.
Yep. That's been the story all game. A lot of contact is left uncalled, and now perhaps Bradley thinking, I don't think Jim Les wanted the foul there. After you force a turnover, you want to try to keep that heat on without fouling.
Yeah, Braves with their eighth team foul, so that sends Falker to the line. Meanwhile, Southern Illinois has a couple fouls to give. They're at five. Well, one foul to give. Randal Falker at the line. He's 1 for 4. Dig. Those threes can get you back in the game in a big hurry, can't they?
They sure can. They can eclipse deficits rapidly. And big free throws there, because when you're a team that's on the lead and the other team has some momentum, you can wreck rallies by knocking down free throws.
8-point lead. Falker with 17 points and 15 rebounds to lead both teams. From the corner, Somerville can't hit. Ball tipped around and finally into the hands of Mullins of Southern Illinois. And the foul will be on the block. Goes against Will Franklin of Bradley. His second.
Boy, Bradley had plenty of chances on that offensive board. Here you take a look at Tatum coming right at you. Boy, Franklin was almost there, and Tatum had that left arm away from his body. That could have gone the other way.
Jim Les thought so, didn't he, on the Bradley
he
bench?
He sure did.
Here's Tatum. Averaging 15 a game. That's his 11th today. And a chance on this second attempt to extend the Southern Illinois back lead back to 10.
And see, Bradley does not have to go for threes, even if they're down 10.
48-38 is Tatum, watched by James and Patricia. They're both teachers. Dad, a college professor, way off the mark was spent on that attempt. And there's a hold as Tony Young came out of the pile with the ball. And the Southern Illinois fans now feel it. 2:12 to go. And the Salukis with a 10-point lead. I believe they're calling that an intentional foul, and that'll give the Young a couple of shots and the ball to Southern Illinois.
Well, it's an easy call to make. That's Patrick O'Brien grabbing the jersey of Tony Young. So I talked about the loss of composure by this Bradley Braves team about 6 minutes ago, and that was another case in point there.
Young now with 6 in the game. Here's his shot at 7. And a 12-point margin for Southern Illinois. 2:12 away from an official invitation to the big dance for Chris Lowry's young team. Patrick O'Brien continues with 4 fouls.
No turning back. Boy, 6 points by Southern Illinois here to thwart the momentum Bradley had picked up by scoring 6 straight.
Negating those 2 Tony Bennett trays. The story of this game will be the Southern Illinois defense that shut out Bradley's team for over 9 minutes. Had only 2 points did Jim Les's team in the first 10 minutes of the second half. And a strategy that was explained to us by Chris Lowry, the young Southern Illinois coach, yesterday. We're going to use up every second of that clock at both ends, and did his team ever deliver. And Tatum connects on another free throw. There's mom and dad. He's a professor at Lincoln College in Jefferson City, Missouri, and she's the supervisor of Jefferson City High School system.
They've got to be extremely proud of their young man. They've made their last 10 free throws now, have the Salukis.
Bennett inside the line to hit a 2. Too little too late for the Bradley Braves. 1:46 to go. Back at the Sabbath Center in St. Louis, and a check of the CBS Sportsline stat of the game. Second half scoring, Bradley with only 19 points and not able to overcome that terrible icy start to this second half when they scored but 2 points in the first 10 minutes. And much of that was when Patrick O'Brien, the 7-footer, sat with 3 fouls, and then His counterpart, Randal Falker, the center for Southern Illinois, took charge of the game.
He sure did. He was everywhere, on the glass, scoring in the paint. Foul there by Bennett on Tatum.
Falker with 17 points and 15 rebounds and a strong double-double performance for Chris Lowry.
Marcellus Somerville, the leading scorer on the season for Bradley, unable to get his game going today. You know, in the win, he had 24 points when these two teams met. But in the loss, he struggled.
And Tatum hits another free throw. He's 5 for 5. And there's Erica Lowry, coach's wife and child. Boy, she's into the game. We watched her the first two rounds, and she's there constantly helping the coach to get a win.
Sometimes it's tougher for the wives than it is for the coaches who have a chance to get that nervous energy out in games and at practices.
Falker with a little frosting on his game, his second block. Oklahoma and Texas, those great rivals down in Texas, able to finish off our triple header. Oklahoma, 4 straight 1-point wins. How dramatic is that play? And Texas still looking for what, maybe a 2 seed?
I think they would be in the conversation for a 1 if they have a strong finish the rest of the way and win the Big 12 tournament.
90 seconds away from the official invitation in Southern Illinois by 11. Let's look at the Braves, 20-9, an RPI of 31, Clark.
Strength of schedule, not that high, but not awful. Key wins, Western Kentucky has won their regular season league conference championship. So, but again, the significant wins primarily in the league. And when you compare that resume with some of the other teams that may be in the similar situation, I don't know if it'll stack up to some of the other teams in terms of their non-conference wins. But they'll certainly be on the board.
Well, in their last 10 games will be impressive,
sure,
because they came into this with 7 straight
That's
wins.
That's right.
And today's Chevrolet Players of the Game here in the Missouri Valley Championship. Patrick O'Brien, most of his points early, 16 in the game, 7 for 10. But how about Randal Falker, 17 and 15. Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund. America's brand supports America's best. Chevy, an American revolution. Tony Young hits another free throw, and that's critical too. You play strong defense, and if you get a lead, you got to be able to go to the line late. You know you're going to be fouled, and when you get to the tournament, teams with good free throw shooting prevail in those tough, tight games.
That's right, Dick. Point well made.
And Young makes it 13 out of 14 from the line for the Salukis. Franklin coast to coast, and not inhibited by the Salukis on the drive. He has 4 points. 1:11 to go.
Well, the Braves showed tremendous fight, but just not enough offense after getting down by mid-double digits here.
Oklahoma and Texas completes our triple header on this Sunday. And of course, looking ahead to next week, we'll have some more conference championships. The Big Ten, I'll be out in Los Angeles for the Pac-10 championship. You go back to the studio and get your notes ready for Selection Sunday, 6 o'clock Eastern time. We'll find out the 65 that'll go for the 2006 NCAA championship.
I think all of the conference tournaments in the power conferences will be very, very competitive. I mean, you're at the Pac-10 next week. The Big Ten has been pretty balanced throughout. Teams scratching and clawing, trying to fortify tournament resumes. So it's going to be another terrific week of college basketball heading towards Selection Sunday.
Southern Illinois, a rare miss at the free throw line. Still got the rebound, but then stepped out of bounds. You see here the Missouri Valley Conference ahead of the Pac-10 in the RPI, and they're ahead of Conference USA as well. Deep in the corner and unable to hit. Danny Adams just in the game. Tony Bennett on the other side, an air ball, and inside the basket scored by Marcellus Somerville, but he's had an off game, only 11 points.
No timeouts for Bradley, and the Salukis attack with Matzell.
That just about seals it tightly for Southern Illinois. Adams from the corner, bodies fly. Both of them in white uniform, and that's going to be an intentional foul against Bradley. just a quick note on the Southern Illinois cheerleader, Christy Yamioka. She's been taken to St. Louis University Hospital for precautionary reasons. Will undergo a series of tests on her head and neck, but as you saw, she seemed to be in good spirit as she
was
taken
away. And that
was
a good sign and a good thing to see as she headed out of here.
Shaw at the line, where he's 2 for 2 today. 14 points now with 8 rebounds. And here's one of those players, Southern Illinois, you don't really notice them until the game's over and say, wow, what a game.
That's right. That's right. They just grind it, Dick. They grind you. They make it tough for you to score. They maximize that shot clock, and they find just enough offense. And when they can combine decent offense with good free throw shooting and the work they did on the glass, they're going to be very uncomfortable for whoever they play against in the tournament.
There are a lot of teams that won't see the smothering defense that the Salukis bring to play.
And the thing about that, Dick, is it wears you down physically and emotionally and mentally. It drains you when guys are in your face for 40 minutes nonstop, and then they're making you play defense for 28, 30 seconds at a time. And a big part today, Dick, was the offensive rebounds, too. That was huge because it gave them extra possession to milk that shot clock.
And their perhaps best defender, Bryan Mullins, really wasn't able to contribute much on that bad ankle.
That's right.
Look at Lowry, the coach. He's battling to the final second, 21.8 seconds, getting in the reserves, and the hand is for the Saluki starters. What a game. What a second half. And what a performance by Randal Falker. And Chris Lowry, with this win today, will become the first coach in Missouri Valley Conference history as a player and a coach to win the tournament title. Smith Peters and the other reserves getting a chance to cap off this Southern Illinois trip to St. Louis that has produced wins against Evansville and Northern Iowa in overtime, and now the Bradley Braves. Falker with 17 points, 16 rebounds to lead the way, and Chris Lowry's Salukis are in the tournament. For Clark Kellogg, Dick Enberg, so long from St. Louis. Final score again, Southern Illinois 59, Bradley 46. Coming up next, our college basketball coverage continues with longstanding rivals Oklahoma at Texas. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports in our 25th road to the Final Four.
To being done. But again, we'll talk to more at the bottom of the hour. Meanwhile, it is March. It is March Madness time. As we approach March Madness, we got to find out who's going to be in the tournament. Southern Illinois hoping for a fifth consecutive appearance. This is the Missouri Valley Championship game, SIU and Bradley, and that's Patrick O'Brien for the Bradley Braves. They led by one at the half. They're the 5 seed entering this tournament. SIU down one until Randal Falker gets the pass and throws it down, and then Falker to match Shaw.
Falker.
Shaw for three.
Shaw.
Beat the Falker, and that to match Shaw for three, and Southern Illinois does go on to win 59-46 of the Salukis. That is a dog, by the way, according to their mascot. The Salukis are going dancing for the fifth consecutive time. Bradley's 7-game winning streak comes to an end. They will need an at-large bid to get in. Their last NCAA tournament appearance was in 1996.